We welcome you back. We told you today's meeting will be much better and quicker. And we can confirm to you that it's quick enough for us to say that even though it's weak, we have made substantial progress, and that we, on government side, regard this meeting today as a conclusive meeting, final of finals, and we discussed dispassionately, and I can report back to you that we touched all the issues. Government has shifted their position as demanded by ASUU on issues of revitalization of the public universities and academic allowances and payments of withheld salaries, and on the issue of mode of payment for the transition period. Whilst their platform, UTAS, is being tested by NIDA. So overall, we have held very fruitful discussions, and government moved from their initial 20 billion for revitalization fund and 30 billion payable now for end allowances in the university system. They moved and brought on the table 15 extra billion, and by that a proposal in one basket for 25 billion revitalization and 40 billion end allowances for all the unions and universities was put in one basket. Second basket offer was or is the issue of revitalization getting 30 billion and end allowances getting 35 billion. So the offer has been made, it's in this document, and ASUU is supposed to come back to government with acceptance of either of one of the offers. Visitation panel, government side, through the NUC, Ministry of Education, as earlier said, these visitation panels have been approved by the visitor to all universities, who is the President and Commander-in-Chief, Muhammadu Buhari, and that while waiting for the gazetting process to be concluded, Ministry of Education will put in motion the processes for the inauguration of the panel, because Mr. President has approved members of the panel. So the visitation panels will be inaugurated in the incoming week, and they'll start their work. And as earlier on agreed in our previous meeting, they'll terminate in December 31st, 2020. And we'll look at issues arising from the past 10 years in those federal universities, broken down into five years. Compartments. We also have agreed on the issue of the renegotiation panel 2009. That panel has been consulted and members have been given their letters of appointment, and their letter of appointment says that they should start work immediately. So that is as good as done. On UTAS, ASUU team have met with the team in the Nigerian Information Technology Development Agency, and they are working together now. So it's work in progress. The National Universities Commission is supposed to have given some kind of leverage to the test by showing where the data centers should be and the rest, user acceptance and other parameters needed. They will do that again next week, and work will continue. We agreed also that the with their salaries are too late to it. It's a component of the issue of no work, no pay that was invoked. And Minister of Education and myself are working on that to get approval for the lifting of the embargo. And when we accomplish this, which is like by Monday we'll start the work on it, as soon as we finish, because there's a transition period between the formalization of IPs, formalization of UTAS, the Office of the Accountant General of the Federation and the University NUC and the Vice Chancellors are to work together to make sure that the retail salaries, when approved, is paid through the old method, the old platform, which Accountant General Office used in paying the salaries of university workers that were not captured on IPs for the months of February, March, April, May, June. They use the same method. The Vice Chancellors, the Executive Secretary, and the Accountant General of the Federation will monitor this and make sure that there are no anomalies as earlier unreported, and manage the process for those payments. Finally, there is the issue of state universities, which the NUC Act is supposed to address, amendment to the NUC Act to give them the powers to exercise their full authority in case some state governments mushroom the universities and lower standards. So work is ongoing on that, and the Executive Secretary NUC confirmed that they have progressed very much in that direction. So we have touched most areas of differences, and ASU has said they were going to go back to their members and their various organs, through their various organs, and they revert back to government on all this. So for the government side, we are the people on this side. I can safely say that they have done their own, and even though I'm a conciliator, I've also participated in putting pressure on the government side and the government to shift their positions so that we can get to where we are. We're on this document that I have initially documents, and ASU has taken their own copy to go back and revert to us. When they revert to us, we can then fix a date for the opening of the universities. Thank you very much. The President of ASU can address you.
The Minister has said so much that I don't really have much to add, but to acknowledge that government has given us some new offers. And we have promised government that we will present faithfully to our members through our organs and report back to government. As we usually say, those of us you see here, we don't have the final say on this matter. But we'll go back to our organs and we'll come back to government with the position of our members on the new offer that we have been given, which is a slight modification to what we got before. But we acknowledge that some progress has been made in some areas. I thank you all for listening. Thank you.
In some areas or many areas.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.